You're listening to the Client Curve Podcast, and this is another OST review. I'm trying to keep these OST reviews limited to soundtracks that you may not have had the chance to hear yet. The first one I did was about an XBLA arcade game, but we're going to shift gears today and go with the Japanese import for the PS2. Okage Shadow King, originally called Boku to Mao, or Me and the Devil King, did only okay on the critical level. I mean, IGN gave it a 7.2, and I only know a few people who actually played it. Even when my sister and I played it, we only played it because our mom picked up the game and said it looked like something we might enjoy. For what it was, I mean, I'd say it's okay. I mean, the rating it got is well-deserved. The gameplay is pretty standard, but the story is really what carries it. I was only able to get about halfway through it. The only reason I'm talking about it today is because it does have a pretty good soundtrack. Though, you'd never really know that if you only played the game for a few minutes. Let me rephrase what I said earlier. It doesn't really have a good soundtrack overall. There are some really good tracks in its soundtrack. The game's music is pretty random and inconsistent. Musically, it's all over the map. Part of the reason would be that it actually had 5 separate composers. You had Takamitsu Kajikawa, Toshiaki Murata, Yasutaka Kume, Yoshikazu Kawatani, and Kazuhide Toda. Do you think that was enough? Having 5 composers leads to a lot of musical disorientation, and honestly, some of the tracks I just don't find appealing. I'd say it's a mixed bag, 50-50 or so. The opening track, Emotional Universe, which is done by Kajikawa, I think is probably the worst track in the entire soundtrack, and that's saying quite a bit. This is supposed to be your best foot forward, the track that hypes you up to play the game. This is what we got. Now that that unpleasantness is behind us, let's move on to the good tracks. This game really is a mixed bag, like I say, and there's a few tracks that are great, and most of the tracks that aren't great are only mediocre at best, if not completely unlistenable. A really good example of sounds that generally work okay are the town themes. I'm going to try and focus on the good songs here, and the town themes are definitely among them. They really help provide a musical backdrop for the area, but they also showcase how different the areas all are. Tenel is the starting town, and its theme kind of sets the overall weird tone of the game. Now, my favorite town theme in the entire game is actually for Madrill. And in a game surrounded by weird and quirky tracks, you have Madrill, which is actually fairly normal, and frankly, it's very pleasant and soothing. It makes a nice reprieve from the usual tracks. also really like what Yasutaka Kume does in the tracks Ruins of Aqua. Now, this is one of the first dungeons you go into, and rather than go for a standard dungeon theme, Kume follows the odd tone that he and his fellow composers have done this whole game, and goes for a pretty unique-sounding dungeon theme. Battle themes in this game are probably among the strongest tracks. I'm going to show you two of them back to back, starting with the normal battle theme by Kume, and then moving into the Evil King battle by Kazuhide Tora. I think you can tell for yourself why I find them so enjoyable. Alright, I'm going to end this OST review with what I think is the best track in the game. Makes sense, as I started it with what I thought was the worst. The Forest of Wilker is the first overworld area you gain access to, and it does a great job of everything that Emotional Universe failed to do. This should have been the main theme. It hypes me up to play the game. All Emotional Universe did was hype me up to press the start button as soon as humanly possible to stop that music. You know what the funniest thing is? Forest of Wilker was also posed by Kajikawa. Not sure what he was going for there, but given that there are so many composers on the project, they probably didn't have as much say in their final product. Who knows? Anyway, this has been Michael with Clanker, and I leave you with The Forest of Wilker by Takemitsu Kajikawa.